Good morning, Drupal Land. This is Shyamala. We're at DrupalCon New Orleans.
Hi, Jam. This is exciting to be at DrupalCon New Orleans. And I'm excited to be here as a board member of the Drupal Association.
So what we're going to do now is walk from our hotel over to the conference venue. And while we're walking, Shyamala's going to hold the camera. And we're going to talk about who she is, talk about the Drupal Association board, talk about what you do, and see a little bit of the city along the way. So if you're listening to the audio version, this is one time when you might want to check out the video too. Okay? Here's the camera. Yeah?
Right?
Yes.
Deal?
Boing.
Welcome to the Acquia Podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
Welcome to the Acquia Podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
Module for that?
There, of course, there is.
Do I cross it and then?
No, let's just let it run.
Okay.
So, how does it feel to be the star today, having a roving reporter following you around town?
It's a nice feeling that there's so many things happening in Drupal.
Uh-huh. So have you had media training already? Because you're very good at changing the subject to what you want to talk about.
Not really, but it's really terrific after this New Orleans DrupalCon and the energy levels there that I feel really excited that I'm part of this. And the New Orleans DrupalCon actually kind of brought a very good mix of diversity, I would say, not just in terms of not just developers, but there was a very good mix of users, businesses, and developers, and kind of shows the maturity of the Drupal platform itself.
Okay. Now, let's turn the camera around so that people can see where we are. So just hold it like that, roughly. So I want to know, how long have you been doing Drupal?
I've been in Drupal for almost 10 years now, and I started Drupal with this
one. Oh, so I know a shortcut down here. Shall we go down here?
I started Drupal with Drupal 4.x. It was a Drupal modal integration. And we were doing it for a company that was doing some learning and paid learning. So we had, at that point, decided that we go open source, and we worked with Moodle and Drupal to set up a platform for them.
Which version of 4.x? Do you remember?
4.7.
Ah, so you had the form API already.
Yes.
There was a...
Yes. But very less documentation. I still remember we had to like literally put print screen in every step of the modules to figure out some of our solutions and, you know, problems that we faced. And
sure. Do you remember when we used to have the PHP snippet libraries to finish the sites? That was still in Drupal 5. There were a ton of those.
Yeah, there were tons of those in Drupal 5. And just after that, we also got an opportunity to engage with a large publishing house in India called Deccan Chronicle. And we did a whole lot of things for them. We were actually their IT partners. And we, at that time, publishing on the web was still very young. And we were kind of pioneers for them to move them to the digital space, and we use Drupal for that.
So do you have a first Drupal memory, like the first time you opened it up? What did you think?
I don't remember the very first memory, but I still remember the very first mistake that we did when we were getting a Drupal site launched.
Tell us.
Yes. So as usual, the main problem was the database had all the user data in it, and we had a site live. We were trying to fix some issues, and we had to download the live database to the local servers. And while testing, we shot out emails to all the users. And I still remember that was like a terrible, you know, breach of privacy for the customer. And it was a lesson hard learned. But yeah, that was one of the first challenges that I faced with.
Always sanitize your development data.
Yeah. Sometimes you just learn it only by doing.
And how many times have you done that since then?
I don't think we repeated it. We were smart enough to make sure that was one of the first steps that we do.
I mean, they say you're allowed to make mistakes as long as you learn from them, right?
Yes, you're very right.
So you've been doing Drupal for most of 10 years, you said. What is it about Drupal that that made you stay? What do you like about Drupal?
I think, so I totally agree that, you know, people come for the code and stay for the community. And when I mean community, it's one is people, another is also talent. I think Drupal has consistently exhibited capabilities and bringing in new ideas and being such a good place to get a lot of passionate developers to do work.
I had the privilege of being in India this year at DrupalCon Mumbai, and it was my first time. And I absolutely, first of all, I just loved being there. I loved the people and the food, and it was a wonderful experience for me. But I was incredibly impressed by the Indian Drupal community. I'm very large, young, enthusiastic, and I have the feeling that as a whole, the community there has understood from the start that it's not just about the code, it's also about people, it's also about all sorts of other things. Can you talk about Drupal in India today and how that's maybe changed in the last 5 or 10 years?
I think there's a lot of adoption by large enterprises. This is changing the Drupal landscape. There's a lot more Drupal developers there. And there's also a lot of awareness that contributing to Drupal is a benefit for them personally. So this is a big change.
I also heard that even the largest companies like Tata Consulting understand that open source developers need to be contributing all the time as well.
Yes, it's amazing that people are looking for other developers who contribute, and they know that there is a certain benchmark that they can associate with people who are contributing, and that's a very it's a big pride for the Drupal community that we have established that.
I was talking with Piyush Poddar in a podcast, I guess that was last year, and talking about India, and he pointed out to me that this concept of karma that we talk about in open source a lot, of course, is an Indian idea. Do you think there's a special good fit between open source thinking and practice and Indian culture in general? Does that make any sense?
This is a very tough question. I think giving is something that's important to any culture. We have probably a very large history and cultural background, so maybe it shows in a more refined manner. But I think as much as we take, I think even in our day-to-day lives, giving is a very important part of what we do. And to that extent, I think open source and India is kind of, I don't think it's any different from anywhere else.
Okay. I wonder, I'm a city person, I live in the city, and okay. I've asked myself sometimes, perhaps people who are practiced at living together, very close together, and having to share resources and be respectful for each other, I wonder if, you know, India's large population maybe makes that sort of respect and cooperation more possible too. It's just something I was wondering, I don't know, because I thought at some point maybe city people are better at open source, I don't know.
Yes, I think maybe we are more respectful of ideas which others bring to the table. And it's a tough question. So why don't you just put that back to me? I'm going to think about it a little bit.
Okay, we'll come back to that in a minute. Yeah. So it's actually only nice and warm today in New Orleans and not unbearably sort of hot and humid like it was yesterday. This is Shyamala, and she's our newest, is it director at large? Is that the title?
Correct.
So Drupal Association director at large. And the directors at large, there are two seats on the Drupal Association board reserved for the community, and there is a voting process every year to vote a new director at large in, and the term goes for 2 years, so those terms are overlapping. You won the last election. I admitted in public that I was very confused by that election and have another podcast out explaining how the process works and everything. What is it that made you want to be on the Drupal Association board?
So I've been with the Drupal community and serving Drupal in different ways. Through the 10 years, I've been consistently contributing to Drupal, and I kind of felt that this new role would give me a larger opportunity to give back to Drupal, and I was also very excited by the energy levels in Drupal India. I thought it was also an opportunity for getting us represented in the Drupal community. So the Drupal project itself and representing India, these were kind of my key motivations.
So the board exists to set direction, create priorities, and perhaps help make policies that then filter out to change things in the community. I think, as Drupalists, a lot of us who are successful, however you want to define successful in the community, are really doers, you know? Open source lets us just go fix stuff. So a lot of us are really like, okay, I see a problem, I'm going to go take care of it. And I think it might be a challenge to be on the board, because the board is not for getting out and fixing stuff. It's for creating the environment where other people can be enabled to do that. Do you think that's going to be hard to just to not just jump into problems, but take a larger perspective, maybe?
This is a really nice question, because I'm kind of understanding that. And very rightly said, I think the board is a strategic body and does not get into the actual implementation. But all of us...
I like that, a strategic body. That's a good way to put it.
And I think, but a lot of us play multiple roles there. It's not like we're just board members. We still continue to exist as community members. We still wear our corporate hat.
Sure.
So which gives us the liberty and flexibility to take on more than what the board defines. As much as the board role is important, maybe our other hats would give us that added flexibility to continue to do what we are passionate about and give back.
So you said that you had two main concerns going in, and one of them was the Drupal community in general helping, and one was representing India in a more prominent way in the community. Talk about your ideas around helping Drupal now.
So I think the key things that I want to do is like, I'm not looking at doing things that are radically different from what Drupal Association has been doing. I just want to facilitate it more. Want to look at how I could assist in adoption, increasing adoption by, you know, evangelizing and speaking about Drupal.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of things that are happening in India, and not necessarily in limiting myself to India, but still it's a good starting point for me. And
I mean, it's such a large place. There's so much potential.
Correct.
There's so many startups, so much business happening now there. I think it's I think it's actually great that we can have a sort of an official representative of the project right there.
Yes. And I just, in this DrupalCon, I also figured that there are more such countries which feel that they are not heard, or they don't have people who speak to them.
Mm-hmm.
More so because our representation and our Drupal community is much larger in North America and Europe. So maybe...
So are you thinking that you can use your position to more people might listen to you when you're talking about the project? It might open a few more doors?
Yes, because I kind of understand some of the their problems in diversity much better than, I wouldn't say much better than, but I kind of understand their diversity and the problems that they face. So I need to see how I can leverage that to further enhance what I could do.
What is your organization?
Unimity Solutions. We are a shop of 50 developers and in Chennai. We pretty much do a large amount of Drupal work. We also have a interesting product called Unimity People Power, which is a social workspace solution.
Okay.
And we have
I will link to that.
Yes.
You're allowed to give your elevator pitch now.
Okay, so we have four very large implementations of our social workspace platform, and which is using Drupal too. So we have pretty much most of the work that we do is in Drupal.
So what are you looking forward to in the next couple of years in Drupal and as an association board member?
I think Dries' keynote was very apt in terms of product strategy. He brought in all the key highlights. And many of those points would really facilitate larger implementations for us, larger enterprises, give us an already established credibility. It will just add on to it for us. I think we have a very good team. We have a very good product. We have...
You mean Drupal?
I mean Drupal, yes. And I know I tend to use the non-community language, yeah. But so it's to make sure that we can have the right direction and we are able to deliver some of the things that we're talking about.
Right, so I think one of the big changes in Drupal 8 compared to previous releases is that it is very much a product. You know, WYSIWYG in core, views in core, the internationalization in core allows us to do so much more out of the box. And we've really thought about the people who work on our websites every day and just make it easy for developers to give them a great experience, right? So the keynote in New Orleans showed a whole bunch more features that really go in the direction of ease of use for end users and what I call productization. But there was media asset management and block management. So yes, that looks like a promising, interesting future.
With personalization.
Personalization, sure. All that, I guess we would call it digital marketing stuff too.
Right.
Here we are at the beautiful convention center. And so we just walked at least several hundred meters through New Orleans on the streets. And the funny thing is that now, the camera's still running. Now, down there, it is literally, I would say, more than a kilometer in this building.
It's a very nice building.
before we get to where the convention is. So I think we'll just keep talking at least until we can find a coffee. So how many DrupalCons have you been to?
I've been to, this is my fourth DrupalCon. Chicago, Amsterdam, Mumbai, and New Orleans.
Those are four really good ones, actually. In Chicago, I loved that we were all in one hotel and everything happened in the same place. And Amsterdam? Wait a minute, you said Chicago? Amsterdam, yeah. Right. Amsterdam, I also had a good time. What do you think of that city? It's very interesting, isn't it?
It's very beautiful. I really enjoyed it. It's pretty. It's easy to travel, and the people are friendly. I did some cycling too. It was good fun.
Right, yeah. Right. And then Mumbai. What did you think when DrupalCon finally made it to India?
It was amazing. I think it gave us a lot of energy. Lots of people there were waiting for this big DrupalCon. Wish we could have one DrupalCon every year in Mumbai.
I would come every... It doesn't have to be Mumbai.
It could be in
India. I would come every year.
I think we need to be just like North America, the other capital for Drupal.
Ah.
India.
See? It's her power play. That's her... now we know what your real ambition is. Move DrupalCon to India. So Dries visited India for the first time in 2011, and they held three Drupal camps very close together so that he could attend them and meet people in the community. Most of the people in the Indian community I've spoken with told me that that was a huge watershed for Drupal. From that moment on, it became more than just a tool for work, and the community sprang up. And, you know, now when you're there, there are thousands and thousands of people, and they're very excited about it. And I'm friends with Ujwal Shah and Rakesh James and Part Gohil and all these other lots and lots of you, forgive me if I don't say your names, community organizers doing trainings every week, every month. Rakesh was telling me that he's trained more than 200 new Drupalists himself. I mean, it's so exciting. So what do you think's next for Drupal in India, and what sort of effect is Mumbai going to have on the community over time?
I think there are going to be a lot more Drupal camps and other opportunities in India. Specifically, just like the events that you have in America. And
except probably bigger.
Yes, probably bigger. And
Hussein was telling me that in Bangalore, if you say, oh, we'll have a casual meetup in a cafe that, 2 days from now, that 150 people will show up, no problem.
Yes. The numbers are... really inspiring. Also, I think there is a need for us to focus on quality of work, because it's important that it's very nice that enterprises are encouraging contributions, because this will then ensure that we not only have large numbers, but we're also having a lot of meaningful participation and some things which are more real use cases that we are actually implementing.
Sure. So you run your own company and you do services, but you also have a product, the social workspace. Talk about the transformation of Indian IT now. So in the past, it's been very much about exporting code, right? A lot of white label service for international companies, a lot of call centers, of course, all that sort of thing. I think I see a move towards now doing IT in India, for India, and I see a transformation of where people are creating their own brands, having their own identities, and also making really amazing contributions, but really taking on an identity instead of being the invisible people behind the scenes.
This is an excellent question. I think the Indian economy and the way we are today, there is a large number of opportunity that we see, which is within India itself. And in fact, when we speak to some of our, as a business user, when we speak to some of our US counterparts, we are engaging with Indians with probably the same rates that we do with our US counterparts. And as long as you're able to deliver business solutions using Drupal effectively, you can still get a premium for what you do. Uh-huh. And there is a lot of opportunity, a lot of work that's happening, especially with IT in India, knowing the Modi government is very keen at IT enabling the country. So there's a lot of opportunity. The government itself is looking at executing a large number of Drupal projects, leave alone general IT. So it's an exciting place to be in India now.
I gave a talk at the government summit in Mumbai, and one of the couple of the slides that I have are from the Cabinet Office in the UK, mm-hmm. where they have this government digital strategy that's been running for a few years, and they've gone open source more and more in centralized and regional IT infrastructures of all the governments. And there are some really, really beautiful slides. Careful now. some really, really beautiful data, actually, that shows before, so that, oh, and I have to say, the government digital standard includes, among other things, it includes a preference for open source where possible. It includes a preference for IT projects under £100 million so that smaller companies can realistically bid for them. And then a couple of other provisions to level the playing field a little bit. But open source is part of that. And the map of government, central government ICT providers before that was basically in London, Reading, Brighton, and one or two other places, all southeast England, all right around London and Brighton, and you could map it directly to Microsoft, HP, IBM, you know, and so on. And with the change in the procurement processes and the preference for open source and smaller projects, the supplier map today goes across all of the islands, you know, all of the UK, Scotland, Ireland, Wales, everywhere. And so it's supporting SMEs and local businesses. And I love the idea that the government can spend ICT money and not send it out of the country, but you can, you know, you can hire your 50-person company in your own town. You can hire a supplier, you know, from your own economy, and that the tax money, you're using my tax money, right? You spend that and you keep it in our economy. And I think that's a really empowering economic story around open source as well.
Very, very true. I mean, I think some of the government summit that you brought to India has been an inspiration for specifically IIT Mumbai, who are our partners. And they're trying to leverage these ideas that you have shared to see if it's a model that they can do in India as well with open source.
I would love to see how that works out, because I think there's so much potential in that.
Yeah. But interestingly, the Modi government is also strategically a very action-oriented government.
Okay.
And there's a lot of, we feel very confident about talking about all this because we know a lot of this is going to get actioned and implemented.
Okay.
It's a very exciting time to be in India, or even associated with India, I would say.
I would love to be associated with India. I'm really looking for excuses to go back. I had such a wonderful time. I was so impressed with the community. I made so many new friends. I'm also incredibly excited about the potential that I see there. Wow. Hey, so we're almost at the conference. Is there anything that I've forgotten to ask you? Is there anything that you wanted to talk about that we haven't hit yet?
I would like to say thank you to everybody who's given me this opportunity. I think it's been people that I've connected through my years in Drupal through a lot of different ways. I thank all those who have shown confidence in my being in this role. And I'm excited to be doing more to Drupal.
Shyamala Rajaram, thank you so much. Take it in the other hand. There we go. Because I'm about to shake your hand, and otherwise we won't be able to. Otherwise we won't be able to do that. Hey, so it's been fun walking around New Orleans together, huh? Interesting. I don't think this is the most exciting piece of the city between our hotel and the conference center, but you know. the tech conference lifestyle is not all that glamorous, so you get what you get. All right. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk with me. It's been really great to meet you in person properly, finally, and I really, really hope to see you again sometime soon, maybe even in India.
Sure. Thank you very much, Jam. I think this conversation has helped me to understand you and know you. It's really nice that this person that I keep seeing on all DrupalCon key pre-notes.
Yes.
Is now somebody that I know.
Ah.
That's really nice.
Fantastic. And then hopefully we can go out and you can show me some of that food in Chennai soon.
Sure. Very much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Shyamala here, and I know I'm being recorded, and I give Jam permission to publish my recording.
And yeah. How much fun has the recording been so far?
It's been terrific. I didn't know I could do this so well.
Well,
I shouldn't say it myself.
You're practically a public figure now, so you're going to have to get used to that.